Just getting a handle on a couple of things here to make certain we know what's going on. Temperatures are the big reason we're starting a little bit late here. We want to make certain that we had the correct information that today was, in effect, the hottest day of the year so far. We came within 2 degrees of the century mark, but again, as I've always said, at some point in time, hot is hot is hot. So we're not seeing anything in the way of any advisories from the National Weather Service regarding the heat. We're not seeing anything in the way of major amounts of heat, thanks to the dry air that's been in place over the course of the last couple of days. That's actually really kind of saved us in its own way because of the fact that it just hasn't been all that steamy hot out there. It's been very hot, yes, but we don't have that much going on in the way of humidity, so that kind of helps things a little bit. Beautiful downtown for the baseball game tonight. Bailey's Heating and Air Camera downtown on the EPB Fiber Optics Weathercam Network. Go ahead and get everybody started and introduced here. Let's see, I think we're good. Let me just double check the microphone. I do everything here, cameras, audio, everything else. So sometimes you have to stop and check and make certain everything's working the way it should be. I'm Chief Meteorologist Austen Onek. Email address at the bottom portion of your screen. If you've got anything in the way of questions for us tonight, please say so. Say hello in the comments section. We're on Twitch and on YouTube. We're on the News 12 YouTube page. And if you're watching this on my channel, that's the repeat of all this, but also live on my Twitch page if you'd like to check out and see what's going on there. Next few days, no question about it, it's going to be just downright hot. No question about that. We'll talk more about the forecast coming up here. Also, it's National Lightning Safety Awareness Week. We'll talk more about that in just a little bit. Came within 4 degrees of a record high temperature today. So that's pretty doggone close of getting toward record temperatures. 65 the low. That was actually below normal. So it was a very nice morning out there. No question about that. So we did not see too much to worry about in the way of very warm weather this morning, but we were still getting a ton of humidity out there. And then also for the next couple of days, the increase in humidity will definitely be back with us. We're already starting to lose daylight by fractions of a few seconds each day, but we will be picking that up and going downhill in the next few days. Still 14 hours and just about 30 minutes of daylight time. Moon will rise on Wednesday morning at 12:15 a.m., so just past midnight, and set around 11:18 in the morning. So that gives you an idea as to what we're looking at there. Let's go ahead and take a look around the area, take a look at a few of our webcams and some beautiful views of some of the temperatures out there. Still close to 90 degrees even after the sun has gone down. From the Patriot Concrete camera, north slope of Lookout Mountain and looking off toward Raccoon Mountain off there in the distance, and showing again some beautiful air, a little bit of sunlight left over, a few clouds well off into the distance for this evening, so not seeing a great deal of major concern. Plainview outdoor advertising camera showing the potential of some clouds here and there. The next possibility of rainfall we have will be coming up in the next few days. More on that in just a little bit. The view from 24 and 75 around south central Chattanooga, it's very dark here. Again, I don't know if that's due to a power failure or because of the fact that some of the lights have been turned off because of the construction going on, but either way, excuse me, street lights are out and it's a little bit darker just south of 2475 and going south toward the Georgia-Tennessee line. So a little bit more caution in some of these darker areas wouldn't be quite such a bad idea. Chattanooga Theater Center, that's the Tomahawk Crane Rigging Camera. Speedy's Total Car Care Camera. A lot of folks out and about downtown and on the North Shore. Lights of AT&T Field lighting up things quite nicely. And a few folks out and about on the footbridge for tonight. And one last one for right now. Taking a look at the Chattanooga Zoo webcam. Remnants of sunset out there with a few more clouds drifting on through. And clouds will be one of the signs we've got in the way of precipitation that'll be heading back our direction. Temperatures back in the mid-80s, calm winds, humidity's a little higher as per normal at this time of the evening, but otherwise not looking at too much going on at this time where it comes to anything really heavy amounts of moisture. A couple of minutes before the top of the hour, temperatures in the 70s and 80s. Again, Scottsboro, you can take your thermometer at the airport out of the refrigerator because I think it's pretty well done at this point. 86 at Powell's Crossroads in Tennessee, and 85 in Tryon, Georgia. 87 in Langston in northeastern Alabama. So some areas are still in that mid to upper 80s range, and we'll continue to see more about that throughout the next several days. Still at 90, well back into the mid-south area, and numbers will continue to be rather toasty on the course of the next couple of days. What we've got, let's go back one more. We'll go to the tropics here in just a little bit. And believe it or not, there is activity in the tropics, but there's just not that much going on for right now. Currently, we're going to be seeing what is left of the dry air sitting over this area. And as what's left of our last cold front washes out across portions of the Atlantic and the Gulf, we've got high pressure and low pressure working together to move moisture up into the plain states, and that's going to be feeding more clouds and the chances of some showers and thunderstorms in advance of this next system. It doesn't look like a lot, but it does look like a potential for more showers and thunderstorms coming up. Tomorrow morning, back to the north of us, we may see some showers and thunderstorms. We'll see better potential for rain and thunder as this next system gets a little bit closer to us. I think the best potential will be after sunset tomorrow night. Taking a look at the Lookouts game tomorrow, can't guarantee there won't be some rain delays if some of this rain sticks around. For Thursday morning, the main part of the energy of this system is going to be well beyond us, way over toward the Canadian Maritimes. And this front, once it gets stretched out, kind of like stretching a piece of taffy out, after a while it gets kind of weak in the middle. So what you're seeing is the front becoming stationary back into around the mid-south and toward the Red River Valley. And that front is going to kind of wobble back and forth across portions of the area. So we may, if we get enough clouds and rainfall, see a bit of a downturn in the temperatures as we go toward the middle part of the week. But right now, that's not a great chance, and that is by no means, and want to make certain this is perfectly crystal clear, not going to be seeing a cool down of any sort coming our way. Might be a little bit less hot, but that's about as good as we can say. That first system continues to stick around through Friday, so that irritation point of that front might be around for a while. And then our next storm system arrives as we go into the weekend. A lot of moisture on this side of the front. Temperatures in the high 90s across much of the area. Combine that, the temperature with the humidity to get that feels-like index, and we could see some heat index numbers above 100 degrees into the weekend. We'll talk more about the extended forecast in just a little bit. The temperature outlook we will get to in just a moment. I want to talk more about severe weather threat. We're not seeing anything in the way of severe weather potential for tonight. Matter of fact, the best potential of any thunderstorms taking place is kind of giving us a wide berth. There's not that much going on. So Nashville, Jackson, Jonesboro, St. Louis, Bowling Green over toward around the area of Springfield, Missouri, might see a marginal threat of severe weather. And again, the scale up here, that's about a 1 out of 5. Now, two things about this next section of the graphic. Number one, it does show the potential of some severe weather in our area. It's a marginal threat. Again, that's a 1 out of a possible 5 on the scale of potential severe weather. Main threat will be damaging winds. If we get anything whatsoever, it'll be borderline strong to severe. The rest of the area south and east of Chattanooga, just generic thunderstorms expected in this pale green area. Now, the other thing to take a look at here, again, it's not a huge amount, but it is still a severe weather threat. Another thing to look at is that this particular day 2 forecast that is issued about twice a day, about roughly midday and about midnight, this forecast is several hours old. So it's a possibility that we could see this really change coming up about 06Z, which is about 2 o'clock in the morning our time, Eastern around here, which means we could see a big improvement or a big ramping up in the way of severe weather, or it might stay exactly the same. We'll have to wait and see. The point is that this information you're looking at, that's the latest forecast we've got, but until we get a new forecast that'll have to do. So we'll have to wait and see what the Storm Prediction Center says in their overnight outlook. And then for Thursday, there's just the potential of some generic non-severe thunderstorms, and that should be about all that we wind up with there. Now, when it comes to the potential of heat, we are not seeing anything at this time in the way of heat indexes going over 105. That is left well on off to our south and west. That's where the hottest of the hot conditions are going to be. But that being said, the Climate Prediction Center short-range forecast going through Independence Day does give us a better-than-average chance of seeing some very hot weather coming our way, especially from here down to the Gulf of Mexico. So we've got the potential for a decent amount of problems where it comes to the heat sticking around. And that is also the case, and I hate to be the bearer of bad tidings, but for the next 30 days, through roughly all of July, the forecast is calling for some very steamy numbers coming up. So little, if anything, going to be giving us any particular amount of relief anytime soon. The worst of the worst appears to be in this more pinkish area, the Outer Banks, Chesapeake Bay, Mid-Atlantic states, Upper Ohio Valley. That is where we may see the hottest conditions more than anything else. We'll be just below that, but no sign of anything involving cooler weather anytime soon. Let's go ahead and take a look at the 7-day forecast. Island Cove, beautiful amounts of some leftover sunset out there, and a few clouds taking place. Now, into the course of the next couple of days, this is where we see, again, the temperatures might dip a little bit with that first storm system coming on through, but numbers will only be back into about the lower 90s at best, and then staying in the mid to high 90s over the course of the rest of the last few days of June, which ends on Sunday with Asteroid Day coming up. The rest of National Lightning Safety Awareness Week will have the potential for an isolated shower or thunderstorm every single day, just not looking at too much in the way of widespread activity. It'd be nice to get that, no questions about that, but for now it's going to be more hit or miss type of activity. You might get something in South Pittsburgh and not wind up with anything down farther south of that into Alabama. You might get something in Ottawa and not get anything in Cleveland. They're going to be that randomly, haphazardly scattered across portions of the area. So right now, isolated activity more than anything else, and that's going to be about all for what we see in the way of anything involving relief. We do see the temperatures continue very mild, low temperatures into the weekend and next week, only dropping into the mid to high 70s. That's the low temperature, so we're just not getting too much of anything out there in the way of relief showing up that'll say we could really get an Arctic blast in here to help us out. Not going to be going on there. And that pretty much continues again for the next several days afterwards. So just really not much good news coming up anytime soon at this point. All right, let's get into several of our extras. Let's go ahead and see here for 1 second. Yes, here we go. Okay, for our sponsor, friendinroofing.com, our weather poll question of the day. Since National Lightning Safety Awareness Week began back in 2005, fatalities from lightning, with the spreading out of more information and about how to stay safe with lightning, those fatalities have dropped from 55 in the late 80s to less than how much over the last, say, 20 years or so. 50, 40, 30, or 20. 30 was the winner, and that was the correct choice. So we've gone from 55 lightning deaths a year to less than 30. So we've basically kind of cut it in half. We do still have a long way to go, though, because 30 lives lost to lightning is way too much, and that is something that National Lightning Safety Awareness Week was designed to talk about, to make certain that people have an idea as to what is going on where it comes to anything involving lightning and safety out there, which is why the National Lightning Safety Council has been promoting and doing a good job of sending out information in regards. Thanks to friendinroofing.com for being our sponsor. Vote now at wdef.com/vote. Vote now for more. If you'd like to know more about National Lightning Safety Awareness Week, you can go to lightningsafetycouncil.org. You can go to the National Weather Service website. You can also, again, keep an eye on our website to find out more about what's going on. Today's topic for Tuesday, just plain basic lightning safety. There is, and this from the National Weather Service and the Lightning Safety Council, there is no safe place outside during a thunderstorm. If you're outside when a thunderstorm, if you can see lightning or hear thunder, you are within range of getting struck by lightning. And you say, oh, well, the odds are low. That's true, but they're not zero. So best opportunity to get off the golf course, get off the playground, get out of the pool. Those lifeguards are not trying to ruin your vacation or cause problems. They're trying to save your life. That's one of the things that they do, is keep an eye on the sky. And if they hear thunder, see lightning, or somebody inside says there's a storm coming, watching weather radar or something like that, it's time to pack it up and get inside. That's the way it works. Again, a good, sturdy, enclosed structure. A tent is not going to cut it. A small gazebo or covered patio out on the golf course, not good. You need to get back indoors again as soon as possible. So all the stuff about Lightning Safety Awareness Week is available here. So check out that for more. Now, this is interesting. I saw this posted today and hadn't really thought about this. This is something that I used to teach going out to classes about how to protect yourself against lightning. The lightning crouch, as it is called, to where you, if there's lightning around and there's nowhere else to go, you don't want to get under a tall tree, you don't want to just go outdoors, you don't want to do anything that's going to attract more lightning to you. You want to, the idea was that the smaller a target you make, crouching downwards and staying on your haunches down on your feet, will reduce the threat of anything involving lightning going in, around, or through you, because you make yourself as less of a target than standing up straight or even just bending over and duck walking trying to get someplace. Your odds of getting hit by lightning are still as good. Your best bet is in a sturdy building. To get there is a time that you need to set aside to plan and say, I need to keep an eye on the weather every 5, 10, 15 minutes, whatever, to see if there's lightning coming in. There's lightning detection apps. There's lightning detection hardware, like a pager. You can carry them around. They're very, not much bigger than an average cell phone that you can use to carry around and detect lightning charges. Lightning has energy in light, in electricity, in heat, in sound waves. It also sends out radio signals, so you're able to detect where the lightning strike is by using that technology. The problem is, if you squat down, you're still in contact with the earth. Even rubber-soled shoes are not going to protect you from getting hit by lightning. So what you want to do is, again, get back inside. And the Lightning Safety Council correctly points out that the lightning crouch, as it is called, has not been officially recommended since 2008. So as of right now, the last 14 years, that is an incorrect way of doing things. This is what science does, to where if you have the opportunity to find shelter from a tornado, you're better off in a ditch than you are in the area in an overpass, because those winds can focus right through and drive debris up your direction. And the best place you can be is in a culvert or a ditch someplace that can allow the debris to fly right over you. That being said, searching for lightning safety can bring up this information, but this is, again, not officially recommended anymore as of about 16 years ago. So the Lightning Safety Council on their Twitter or X feed, I guess it's called now, we need everyone in the weather community to share the correct information so the wrong information gets dropped in the search ranking. So what you see when you see lightning crouch, that is not the way to do it anymore. That is not the safest way. The safest way is to get off the golf course, get out from outside, back indoors again, and wait again 30 minutes until you hear the last lightning, see the last flash of lightning, hear the last rumble of thunder, or again, it moves 30 miles beyond where you are, because even 30 miles away, that storm can send out a bolt from the blue, which can strike you even though you're 30 miles out. So that's something we'll be talking about tomorrow. But in the meantime, the big no-no on the lightning crouch, as it is called. More on Lightning Safety Awareness Week coming up in the next several days, so keep it tuned to News 12 for more. We haven't really been talking about the tropics the last few days because technically there's been nothing going on out there, but there is one thing happening, and of course naturally I would move it to where I am not able to find it. Okay, here we go. So we do have one system. Keep in mind when you see this map, the Sahara is belching out a ton of information of sand and dust coming over this general area. So we do not have a lot going on where we see anything happening here. What we have is one disturbance here that is, again, swirling around this little pocket of tropical moisture. Dry, dusty air is surrounding this thing, but the dusty air and the area of low pressure is actually moving in tandem to where it's still getting a good amount of moisture, helping out with what is could be more development as it moves this direction. Now, going across the Southern Caribbean, heading across the Yucatan Peninsula and then into the Bay of Campeche again, this could set up very similar to what we saw with Alberto just about a week or so ago. So we could be looking at another storm system going on through here if this one just north of South America continues to develop. Now, off, as long as I'm showing you this, I'm going to zoom out just a little bit further here and see what we've got. What we have is another area developing. So I'm going to take this, copy and paste, and then I'm going to move this all the way over here because this is just right off of Africa and south of the Canaries. We've got another storm system developing, and this one might be hampered by the dust that we are seeing out there from around the Sahel. Whether or not it does, it's kind of hard to say now, again, for now, but it looks like the National Hurricane Center is, oh, that's not going to work. All right, so hang on, I was trying to put a jet stream in there. It looks like this system, which is seeing about the same amount of development chances, about 20% here, will be moving into this area. And for right now, the National Hurricane Center is saying some slow development of this system is possible into this weekend and early next week while it moves generally westward. Pretty fast clip, about 15 to 20 miles per hour. So we are seeing a little bit more development possibility here. It depends on what all that dust over the Sahara chooses to do, whether or not that kind of blocks out more sunlight and prevents development. We'll have to wait and see just what exactly we might be looking at there. But that's number two. First one over here, second one just off of Africa. So we should be watching that one as well as it moves, again, generally to the west-northwest. So we're starting to see kind of a ramp up. That's the, I believe, the fifth or the sixth system in general in the News 12 viewing area. So, or in the tropics so far, not affecting the News 12 viewing area. I haven't had enough coffee this entire day today, so I apologize for that. So for right now, that's about the biggest weather stories that we have of the day. Thanking News 12 viewer Enes de Sepio, I hope I'm saying that correctly, from Dunlap. Sunset last week, about 10 days ago, in the Sequatchie Valley around Dunlap. Beautiful colors out there. Love this time of the day. When you can see the sunlight reflected through the thicker part of the atmosphere at that angle and reflecting off the clouds. Beautiful. If you'd like to see this picture yourself, all you have to do, it's very simple. If you'd also like to drop your pictures off, all you have to do is email them to us, drop them to our social media pages, or go to wdef.com/photos. If you'd like to submit your picture for the Langley Roofing weather window picture of the day. And thanks to everybody for sending in some wonderful pictures, but we're going to continue to see hopefully more of those out there. Please tell your family and friends to send their, as long as it's weather related, we would like to be able to see it. So go ahead and send it in to us. We'd like to know more about what you've been seeing out there for right now. Okay, is that it? I think that's it. That might be it. We're going to go a little bit less longer than what we usually do. There is really just not that much going on for tonight, but that's okay. I think we've done everything. Hurricanes, lightning, weather picture, weather poll, that should pretty much do it for tonight. So I think we'll go ahead and send it back to your regularly scheduled Tuesday evening for more information there. Please keep it tuned to News 12. Again, we'll keep you updated. Website at the bottom of the screen, wdef.com/weather. Please tune in tonight at 11. Andrew Harrison on news, Rick Nyman on sports, and yours truly on weather. We'll keep you updated as to what's happening. And, of course, Chip Chapman will have more on your forecast bright and early. Excuse me, tomorrow morning, Wednesday, peak of the week, starting at 5 a.m. So stay tuned for more out there. And as always, let's be careful with that heat going on. Let's just be careful out there in general, but especially when it is this hot and going to be getting a lot more humid into the course of the next several days. I'm Chief Meteorologist Austen Onek. Thanks for joining us for Tuesday night's edition of Weather Overtime. And stay tuned for more with News 12 on air and online.